I'm stuck using iOS and iPhone, and that's not necessarily a bad thing, but I wanted to go over why. Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and here's a few reasons why I'm currently stuck using iOS. Now the first one is probably pretty obvious if you've been following me for any amount of time. I've been using iPhone for a very long time. That means I've recommended them to friends and many more, and just about every single person I know, with the exception of two people that I talk to regularly, uses an iPhone. And that brings me to my first point, iMessage. iMessage has me locked in so that it's very hard to go anywhere else. The reason I say that is not only does it work on iPhone, but it works on iPad and Mac, and it's just seamless between all of them. It syncs with iCloud and it makes things very easy. Now, if you're outside of the US, this may not be as familiar to you because maybe not as many people use it, or they might use something such as WhatsApp. However, in the United States, out of all my friends and family, only two people use Android. So every single person is on iMessage. You can see whether or not they've read the reply, if they have read receipts turned on. It's very easy for group messages, and of course it's encrypted end to end. If we go into it, so within iMessage, you can see here that I have high quality links, photos I've shared that stay very high quality, and then of course your keyboard is end to end encrypted and doesn't use any texts unless you need to switch to SMS, which it can do on its own. So if you're texting with someone on an Android phone, it just automatically jumps to SMS messaging and sends to that Android phone. So that's something that's really helpful. And out of all my friends and family, like I said, there's only two people that don't use an iPhone. So in the United States, iPhones are pretty much the main thing around, at least for my family and friends. That doesn't mean that's the way everywhere, but people that don't have iMessage in the United States don't always just jump to WhatsApp. They typically use the default messaging app that's installed, like on the Pixel with the Google messaging app. So the Pixel here, they'll just use the default messaging app instead of something else. Of course, you have those options, but right now that makes it very hard to leave iPhone. With just the simplicity of syncing across devices, it's super useful, and of course it's end-to-end encrypted, so that's something. Also, WhatsApp is owned by Facebook, and many people don't care for Facebook. They don't trust them, at least a lot of friends I know, and so they would much rather have Apple manage messages and have it end-to-end encrypted there. Now, the second reason is Find My Friends. Now, this may not be a huge issue for many people, and you technically can do this with Google Maps, where you can locate your friends and family. And I probably use this more than most people do. However, I have 15 people that I follow or that follow me. Let me go into it. And as you can see, there's a bunch of people spread across the East Coast of the United States. So every one of them are family members and one friend that have access to my location, and I have access to their location at any time. And this is super helpful, especially for your direct family. So my own children, my wife, if I ever need to know where my kids are, maybe they're going to a store, maybe I want to see if they've arrived to a mall safely, I'll be able to go in here and check. So this is something I use every single day just to see where people are, and people use that the same for me if I ever get together with family and more. So it just makes things very convenient. Also, it traces devices and items as well. So I have items such as the AirTags on a backpack, and then also my keys. I don't typically lose things, but if I ever need to find them, I can easily. And then my devices such as my iPad or iPhone. So that makes it super convenient and something that we all use, and it's very difficult not to use that if I was to switch to Android. I'd have to have my entire family switch to doing that on Google Maps or a third-party app. Now, to go along with that and iMessage is FaceTime. FaceTime, again, is something I use a lot with my family, whether that be a multiple call with different family members at once or just with me and someone else, I use that all the time. Now, of course, there's alternatives such as Google Duo and others, but this is something, again, with my direct family, 15 people and friends and more, it just makes things super convenient and easy. I have one family member that actually just bought an iPad so he can use the same thing because we're all using Apple devices. And again, it's encrypted and everything else. So it's just convenient, something that we all use, and of course works between iPhone, iPad, and Mac. Now, something that's not necessarily as important, but I use every single day, is AirDrop. Now, Apple and Google have the same sort of functionality, but Apple's been doing it longer now. And so if I go into Photos, in Photos, you can see I have a wallpaper selected, so I'll just AirDrop it to my iPad here. And you'll see here, it'll take a second, and then it airdropped to my iPad. So I have the photo, it's the wallpaper from here, just makes things super easy. Now you do have those things with Nearby on the Google Pixel and other Android devices, but it doesn't seem to be as seamless and it's only more recent. So it does work. I've used it quite a few times already, but it doesn't seem to work as well for me, but it does work between Android phones, but not Android phones and iPhones or Macs. I wish this was an open standard. And that leads me to, should Apple be forced to make these open standards? If you've been following along with the European Union, it looks like they're going to be mandating certain sort of laws that may force Apple to open their platform up to things like that. So one of them is iMessage. Now, I'm not necessarily against them opening up iMessage to different platforms. I think it would be super nice to have an alternative to things such as Telegram, Signal, and WhatsApp, or just the default messaging app. So if we had iMessage that worked across not only iPhones, but Android and maybe even Windows, I would love to see that. Now, whether or not that should be forced upon Apple is something completely different and a different discussion. Now, FaceTime, when it was introduced by Steve Jobs, he said that it would be open and others could use it, and then they just never did that. So I would love to see FaceTime integrate with something like Google Duo or maybe other video chat apps that would just make it super easy to use whatever you want to use and just work independently of whatever device you're using. Of course, that takes away from Apple's sales and the reason you have device and ecosystem lock-in. So that's something that we may never see, but Steve Jobs actually said it was going to be an open industry standard. We just never saw that. And the other thing they may be forced to do is open up everything else, whether that be the App Store and sideloaded apps or third-party apps. Apple may be forced to do that, and it looks like that could be sooner rather than later, according to the European Union. So that's something that's looking closer and closer to becoming a reality, and at this point, we may see, but we just don't know at this point. So we'll have to see later this year if they actually force Apple to do that along with USB-C on the bottom and making things more interoperable between different platforms and different devices. So switching for me between an iPhone and another iPhone is super simple, but switching between an iPhone and an Android phone makes things much more complicated and complex. Now I do switch full time when I do reviews of things such as the Pixel. I'll put my SIM card in it and then I'll switch, and my wife just knows what to expect as far as that goes. But it is a huge inconvenience for not only my wife, but my entire family, including my children. Now again, this could be changed if Apple is forced to open everything up. Now I've been using Android for a very long time, since the original public version with the HTC Dream. So I've been using Android on and off for a very long time. There's things I like about it, things I don't like about it, but I definitely would welcome being able to more easily switch between different things. But whether or not Apple should be forced to do that is a discussion for another time. Now, with all those things I've mentioned, I'm not complaining at all. I'm just saying that those are the reasons I'm using iOS and iPhone. And of course, if you've followed me for any amount of time, you know that I cover every single update and have for many, many years. So I've been doing iOS updates, all the beta updates, and much more. But I've also been covering Android updates for quite some time. Now, I don't necessarily cover every single one of them, but it's just something that I'm aware of what both are capable of, and both are great devices with great operating systems. So some have advantages over the others. So Android 13 or One UI might have an advantage over iPhone in some ways, and iPhone has advantages over Android in some ways. So being stuck using any one of these is not really a problem. It's just something I wanted to mention where there's really ecosystem lock-in, and maybe that will change in the future. But iOS updates, of course, I make all of those videos and also share tips and tricks and everything else, and it's what I've been doing for years. So I don't plan to stop anytime soon, but I'll also carry Android with me from time to time also. I keep it in my backpack, and this Pixel is what I'm currently carrying now, every single day along with me. So I'm not really stuck in the sense that I can't get out if I ever want to, but it makes it very difficult with those messaging apps and Find My and more that I mentioned already. Not to mention shared subscriptions such as Apple Music, which will work on Android, but other apps as well. Apple Arcade, the App Store, and all of the apps I've bought for years make it more and more difficult to get out of using iOS, but I don't really want to get out of using iOS. There's things I would change, of course, and we'll see iOS 16 soon, and I think we'll see some good changes with that. So with all of those things, I'm not really stuck in the sense that I can't ever get out, but I'm stuck in the sense that it's very hard to change once you're actually using things to their full capacity. But let me know your experience in the comments below. Are you stuck using iOS? Are you stuck using Android? Or are you enjoying using either one of them? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.